We want to solve the system of equations using the substitution method. To solve a system of equations means to determine the ordered pair or x and y value that's going to satisfy both of the equations. We learned when solving systems graphically that it's possible to have one unique solution consisting of one x value and one y value, but it's also possible to have no solutions or even an infinite number of solutions. Let's review the steps for solving a system using the substitution method, and then we'll solve this. The first step in the substitution method is to solve for a variable in one of the equations. Step 2, we substitute in the other equation for the variable isolated. And then step 3, we solve the equation that will now contain one variable. Step 4, perform back substitution to solve for the other variable, and then we should check our solution. Now looking at our example, notice how the second equation is already solved for y, so we can use this and perform substitution into the first equation. If we know y is equal to 2x, we can replace y in the first equation with 2x, and this will give us an equation with one variable. So let's call this equation 1 and this equation 2 just to keep things organized. So using equation 2, we'll substitute into equation 1. So equation 1 would be x plus, instead of 2 times y, we'll have 2 times 2x. Again, y is equal to 2x, and then we'll have equals negative 20. Notice how the equation now only contains one variable, so we can now solve this equation to determine the value of x. So we'll have x plus, this would be 4x, equals negative 20. And x plus 4x, or 1x plus 4x, is 5x. Divide both sides by 5, and we have x equals negative 4. Now we need to be careful here because we're not done. Remember, the solution consists of one x value and one y value. So we know x must equal negative 4, but now we need to perform back substitution into one of these two equations to determine the value of y. Let's go ahead and use equation 2 to determine the value of y. We know y must equal 2 times x, and we know x is negative 4, so y is equal to 2 times negative 4, which is equal to negative 8. So our solution is x equals negative 4 and y equals negative 8, which can be expressed as an ordered pair, where the first coordinate would be negative 4 and the second coordinate would be negative 8. Now, because this is the solution of the system, it should satisfy both of these equations, and let's go ahead and check that. We'll substitute negative 4 for x and negative 8 for y into equation 1 and equation 2. So using equation 1, we would have negative 4 plus 2 times negative 8 equals negative 20. Let's make sure this is true. We'd have negative 4 plus negative 16. And negative 4 plus negative 16 is negative 20, so this checks. But we also need to verify this ordered pair would satisfy equation 2, where y is equal to 2x. So we'd have negative 8 equals 2 times negative 4, which also checks. So this verifies that our solution is correct. And just to make the connection to how we solve a system of equations graphically, remember if we were to graph these two lines on the same coordinate plane, this should be our point of intersection. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. Here's the graph of equation 1. Here's the graph of equation 2. And notice that our point of intersection here does have the coordinates of negative 4, negative 8, which again is the solution to our system of equations. We'll take a look at another example in the next video.